Hieron was the king of Syracuse in Italy. He wanted crown from pure gold. He asked his goldsmith to make one for him. After some time, goldsmith came with a very attractive crown for the king. However, king suspected that crown is not completely made of gold. It might have some other metal like silver inside it. He did not want to break it as well. How can he know for sure that crown is not made from 100% gold? He asked everybody in the city, but nobody knew how to prove it. Archimedes was a great scientist in his kingdom. He thought long and hard, but could not find a method of proving that the crown was not solid gold. One day, while taking a bath, he noticed that water spilled out of the tub as he entered. This incident gave him a clue. What if he can do the same with gold crown for the king? He was so excited that he ran naked through the streets shouting Eureka. Eureka in Greek means I found it in English. We will soon find out how he actually did it. Archimedes used analog of the bath incident to solve the problem of crown. This is where science helps us to find solution to everyday problems. It brings out creativity in all of us. We learned that buoyant force acts on an object when it is submerged or floating in fluid. We use different fluids like water, oil to verify the same. But what is the magnitude of this upward force? Let me take this eraser. What will happen if I dip it in water? It sinks. What happens to the level of water in the container? It rises. As water is fluid, space initially occupied by it is taken up by container. How much space it has taken? If we press this eraser in the dough and remove it, it has created a space equal to its volume. Let us dip this eraser in plastic bottle, which is completely filled with water. When we dip eraser in it, water spills out. We will collect water spilled out in the dough. It is equal to the volume of eraser. As you are aware, mass is measured in grams or kilograms. Force is measured in newtons. Weight is the force due to gravity. This spring scale measures the force due to gravity on the object. Let us take this eraser. Its length is 6 cm, width 2 cm and height 1 cm. Its volume will be length multiplied by width multiplied by height. It is 12 cubic centimeters. Mass of eraser is 29 grams. Its density is more than 2 grams per cubic centimeter. It will sink in water. I can attach this eraser to spring balance and measure the force due to gravity. It is 0.29 Newton approximately. Let us attach this eraser to spring balance. We will hang it like this. We will keep glass to pour water. What will happen if I start pouring water in the glass? Will there be any change in spring balance reading? What about the level of eraser in the glass? As we start pouring water, level of eraser slightly goes up. Even spring balance indicates less force. Let us watch it in slow motion. Earlier, we learnt about buoyant force. Water exerts a buoyant force on the eraser. When it is completely immersed, it is 0.17 Newton. The difference of 0.12 Newton is due to force exerted by water on eraser. This is an upward force. It opposes force due to gravity. What caused the difference in force? It is the water displaced by the eraser. We will calculate the volume of displaced water by collecting water spilled by eraser. This container is filled completely. As I immerse this eraser in water, it replaces water equal to part it is inside water. When fully immersed, it has displaced water equal to its volume. It is slightly more than 12 cubic centimeter. Mass of this water is 12 grams as density of water is 1 gram per cubic centimeter. Force due to gravity for this mass is 0.12 Newton. This explains the difference in force we experienced earlier. Buoyant force exerted on the object in fluid is equal to the weight of the fluid it displaces. What will be buoyant force when we use salt water instead of plain water? It will be more, as the same volume of salt water is denser. It has more weight. Spring balance shows reading of 0.12 Newton. If eraser is 10 cm in length instead of 6 cm, what will be buoyant force when it is immersed in water? You can calculate the volume of eraser which is regular in shape. What about the volume of irregular shape like this stone? We can fill the container till the brink and immerse the stone in water. Spilled water is collected in a container and its weight measured. How will you decide buoyant force acting on it? Buoyant force on the stone is equal to the weight of the water displaced. Eraser was denser than plain water as well as salt water. It sank in both. It displaced water equal to its volume. What about objects that float? Average density of floating object is less than the fluid they are floating in. Floating objects also displace some fluid. Let us explore this with the help of syringe. We will cut this syringe. Opening is sealed to prevent water from entering it. It is very light and floats on water. We will use coins to make it a little heavy. Mass of syringe is 9 grams and the average mass of the coin is 5 grams. With 3 coins, it floats on water, just like a ship. Its combined mass is 24 grams. What will happen if we add more coins to the syringe? It will become heavier. Its average density will change. It will go down slightly. As we add more coins, it goes downwards. Buoyant force due to water is pushing it upward. Force due to gravity is pulling it downward. It is now greater with 4 coins than with 3 coins. How much coins are required to make it sink? When force due to gravity is greater than the buoyant force, it sinks. How will you measure the buoyant force for the syringe? We will measure the amount of water displaced. When we added it for the first time, it displaced 24 milliliters of water, which is identical to the weight of the syringe and 3 coins. As we add more coins, 5 milliliters of water is displaced by the syringe. This is equal to the weight of the coin. At this point, adding more coin will increase its total weight. This will result in its average density greater than that of water. It sinks. Ships work on the same principle. Average density of the ship, that is the weight of the ship, goods on it, and the air is less than one which is a density of water. Ships float on water. Archimedes' principle. The manner in which buoyant force acts is summarized by Archimedes' principle, which states that the magnitude of the buoyant force always equals to the weight of the fluid displaced by the object. Buoyant force acts vertically upward. People are riding in this hot air balloon. Density of hot air is less than surrounding cold air. As a result, hot air balloon rises upward. Challenge. Volume of this plastic container is 75 cubic centimeters and its mass is 10 grams. Each marble has a mass of 5 grams. If I put 10 marbles in the container and close the lid, it floats in water. How many more marbles are required so that container sinks in water? Summary. Buoyant force is an important concept. We performed activities to understand how buoyant force exerted on the object in fluid is equal to the weight of the fluid it displaces. This helped us to understand Archimedes' principle. Do try these activities yourself to experience it better. Thank you.